Hey guys, this is DG. Today, we are going to learn about OSI Model or Open System Interconnection Model. So let's start. OSI Model defines and is used to understand how data is transferred from one computer to another in a computer network. In the most basic form, two computers connected to each other with LAN cable and connectors sharing data with the help of network interface cards forms a network. But if one computer is based on Microsoft Windows and the other one has Mac OS installed, then how these two computers are going to communicate with each other? In order to accomplish successful communication between computers or networks of different architectures, 7-layered OSI model or Open System Interconnection Model was introduced by International Organization for Standardization in 1984, containing application layer, presentation layer, session layer, transport layer, network layer, data link layer, and physical layer. Note that each layer is a package of protocols. If I say application layer, then it does not mean that it includes computer applications like Chrome, Firefox, etc., but it includes application layer protocols that are needed to make these applications work correctly in a network or internet. Let's start with the topmost layer, application layer. Application layer is used by network applications. Network application means computer applications that use internet like Google Chrome, Firefox, Outlook, Skype, etc. Web browser is a network application running in your PC. It does not reside in the application layer, but it uses application layer protocols HTTP or HTTPS to do web surfing. Not only web browser, but all network applications including Outlook, Skype, etc. all are dependent on application layer protocols to function. There are dozens of application layer protocols that enable various functions at this layer. All these protocols collectively form application layer. These protocols form the basis for various network services like file transfer, web surfing, emails, virtual terminals, etc. File transfer is done with the help of FTP protocol. Web surfing is done with the help of HTTP or HTTPS protocol. For emails, SMTP protocol is used, and for virtual terminals, Telnet is used. So, application layer provides services for network applications with the help of protocols to perform user activities. Next to application layer is presentation layer. Presentation layer receives data from application layer. This data is in the form of characters and numbers. Presentation layer converts these characters and numbers to machine understandable binary format. For example, conversion of ASCII to ABCD code. This function of presentation layer is called translation. Before data is transmitted, presentation layer reduces the number of bits that are used to represent the original data. This bit reduction process is called data compression, and it can be lossy or lossless. Data compression reduces the amount of space used to store the original file. As the size of file is reduced, it can be received at destination in a very less time. That is, data transmission can be done faster. Thus, data compression is very helpful in real-time video and audio streaming. To maintain the integrity of data, before transmission, data is encrypted. Encryption enhances the security of sensitive data. At sender side, data is encrypted, and at receiver side, data is decrypted. SSL protocol or Secure Sockets Layer protocol is used in presentation layer for encryption and decryption. So, presentation layer performs three basic functions: translation, compression, and encryption/decryption. Now, session layer. Suppose you have planned for a party. You have hired a few helpers ensuring that each activity runs smoothly. Helpers will help you in setting up, assisting, cleaning, and then closing the party. Same is the case with session layer. Session layer helps in setting up and managing connections, enabling sending and receiving of data, followed by termination of connections or sessions. Like you hired some helpers for your party, session layer 2 has its own helpers called APIs or application programming interfaces. NetBIOS or Network Basic Input-Output System is an example of APIs which allows applications on different computers to communicate with each other. Just before a session or a connection is established with the server, server performs a function called authentication. Authentication is the process of verifying who you are. For this, server uses a username and a password. Once entered username and password are matched, a session or a connection is established between your computer and the server. After authenticating the user, authorization is checked. Authorization is the process used by server to determine if you have permission to access a file. If not, you will get a message saying you are not authorized to access this page. Both of these functions, authentication and authorization, are performed by session layer. Session layer keeps a track of the files that are being downloaded. For example, a web page contains text, images, etc. These text and images are stored as separate files on the web server. When you request a website in your web browser, your web browser opens a separate session to the web server to download each of these text and image files separately. These files are received in the form of data packets. Session layer keeps a track of which data packet belongs to which file, either text file or image file, and tracks where the received data packet go. In this case, it goes to web browser. That is, session layer helps in session management. So, session layer helps in session management, authentication, and authorization. Your web browser performs all functions of session, presentation, and application layer. If you have learned something from this video, then please like this video. Share this video so that more people can learn. Subscribe to TechTerms if you want to learn more, and turn the notification icon on. Thanks for watching.